All right, guys. So now that we got the majority of the mindset stuff down, now that we got your short-term goals, your long-term goals, and all that good stuff, now we're going to talk about how much it costs to start a construction company. This is going to vary depending on where you're at in your timeline of starting your business, right? Some people are going to have a lot of money to get started. Other people are going to have no money to get started. I'm basing it off of what we used and how much money we needed for what we were doing. Now, keep in mind, at the time, we're dealing with, you know, six-figure contracts already off the bat. So we needed a decent amount of money to get started. However, if you're just starting off doing little $5,000, $10,000 kitchen remodel jobs or, you know, home improvement jobs, you're not going to need this much money to get started. However, this is just a complete breakdown of roughly what you can look to spend when you're getting started in a, like a legit construction company. So first things first, you're going to need to go to the contractor state license school, get your education, and pass your exam. Now, depending on where you're at in life, if you have no experience and no knowledge of the trade or anything like that, then you're not going to be the one doing this. Your partner is going to be the one doing this. However, if you're the one that has the experience and you have the qualifications to get your own license, you don't have to go to school, but you can just sign up to take the test and submit the application and everything. However, I would recommend going to school because there's a lot of law, you know, safety questions that are in the exam. There's a lot of trade questions, obviously. So it'll be good to go to school and take a crash course or whatever, so you have a better chance of passing your license exam. Now, here in California, when I went to the Contractor State License School, their full course, which is basically online and in person, it's a 4-week course and you go once a week. That course was $1,200. But they also offer a crash course, which was $495. And the crash course is basically just pretty much all online, and they just send you the materials and you study on your own. Depending on how comfortable you are and how you'd like to learn, you can either go to the in-school and do the online, or you can just do the crash course. That's really up to you guys. So you're probably gonna spend about $1,200 just to go to school to pass your exam. Number two, you're gonna have to submit your application for your license. So here in California, the fee just to submit your application is $330. Then once you submit your application, you get accepted, you're going to need to get a bond, a surety bond, which basically a surety bond is just legal document that ensures that you're going to pay your suppliers, vendors, whoever you're doing business with, and provide your services. That costs about $150 a year, depending on, like, again, what type of business and trade you're going into. Number four, you're going to have to register your business or your LLC, S Corp, whatever you're going to do. And that typically runs about $800. If you use LegalZoom, it'll run you about $800. If you use like a private consultant, sometimes they charge up to like $1,200 or whatever. So registering your business costs about $800. Everything that I'm telling you guys applies to California. Now, it may be similar in other states, but just keep that in mind when you're going through this. The process should be roughly the same. The cost will be roughly the same, but just know that I'm basing all of this off of California laws and regulations. Also, registering your business is just a one-time fee. You don't have to pay every year to register. However, you do have to pay yearly tax, which is $800 too. And whenever you register a business, you have to pay $800 to the state to just to have your LLC open. Number five, insurances. Insurances are going to vary, guys, depending on what, you know, how many cars you have, depending on how many employees you've got. Like, insurances are going to vary a lot. For SoCal, our insurances are roughly $10,000 a month. Now, for you guys just starting out, it's not going to be that much. It's going to be, you know, way cheaper. It might be like $1,500, $2,000 a month, depending. I have over a dozen vehicles. I have over a dozen employees, you know, so that's why, you know, for me, it's roughly $10,000 a month. Your insurances are broken down. You can have as many insurances as you want. However, the three main insurances that you're going to need a commercial auto policy, which is for your work trucks, not your personal vehicle, for your work trucks and all that stuff. You're going to need a general liability policy, and you're going to need workers' compensation. This is mandatory. You cannot operate and get any contracts without having your insurances intact. You can't do any big, like, legit contracts without having these, because every time you're getting ready to bid on a project, if you do end up getting it, usually the client always requests a certificate of insurance, which basically is just proof that you are insured, and it shows them the policies you got and, you know, the amounts and all that stuff. So this is mandatory. You're gonna have to get these policies, but like I said, it depends on how many cars you got, how many employees you have, how many claims you have, like all that stuff. All that's going to affect how much you pay in insurance. Number six, your equipment. Now, like I said, if you're just starting out and you're just doing little $5,000 remodel jobs or, you know, small little carpentry work or repairs and stuff like that, you're not going to need this much. However, for us, because we already had a large contract signed and ready to go, we needed equipment to get the jobs done. Like, our first contract was like 10,000 feet of fence. You know, that's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of holes that we had to dig. We're not going to dig them by hand. So obviously we needed a truck for the guys to move around to the job site and back and all that stuff. And then we needed a tractor in order to, you know, a tractor with an auger attachment to dig all the holes. So, you know, the work truck, we started off with a used one. We got it for like 15 grand. It was a 2008 GMC Sierra. However, if you have good credit and you want to finance and you think you're going to be in business for a while, a decent truck is going to run you about 35 grand, like a work truck with like utility bed, with toolboxes and all that stuff, 35,000. A skid steer or an excavator, depending on what you're doing, whether if you're gonna be excavating, if you're gonna be just, you know, leveling dirt, if you're gonna be digging holes, whatever, you're gonna need either a tractor or an excavator. And typically, a used one is gonna run you about 50 grand. You're gonna need power tools. Power tools, like I said, it just depends on what trade you're doing. Your power tools are gonna vary depending on your trade. So you're gonna need drills, you're gonna need saws, you're gonna need a measuring tape, levels, gloves, markers, you know, pens. There's so many things, you know, generators, welders, whatever it's gonna be for your trade and what you need to complete your job is gonna vary. But I'd estimate about 5 grand on the higher end if you already have like a big contract and you need multiple tools. Cause like, let's say you're gonna be running multiple crews for different things, it could run you up to like 5 grand just to start, cause you're gonna need tools for everybody. You don't just wanna have one drill, you wanna have multiple drills so each person can contribute and do their job. Last thing, if you get a skid steer or an excavator, you're gonna need a trailer. Why? Cause the trailer, you're gonna use the trailer to haul your equipment, you're gonna use the trailer to haul your materials, pick up pallets of concrete, pick up pallets of material, bricks, whatever you're gonna need, a trailer. It's pretty much a must in any type of construction, even landscaping and stuff. Like, you gotta haul your tree trimmers, you gotta haul, you know, all kinds of different equipment. So roughly in equipment for like a higher end company that's getting started with like a bigger contract, you're probably gonna spend about 95-100 grand. Your truck, your tractor, your tools, and your trailer. Now you have employees. Now employees are expensive, man. So if you're gonna hire somebody, make sure that they're good at what they do and make sure that they're gonna make you money. The whole purpose of an employee is not just to hire somebody to help you. You want somebody who's not only help you on the job side, but help you make money. So someone who's gonna take care of your stuff, someone who's not gonna damage tools, you know, someone who's careful, who cares about their job. Because I've gone through many nightmare employees, bro, that don't take care of stuff. I had a guy run over, you know, a brand new welder that I got. I've had people, you know, damage generators, they drop generators, and it's a disaster. So, and an employee is a big investment, so you don't want to just hire whoever. Just imagine one employee, let's say you pay him $18 an hour, let's say he works 80 hours a week, in 12 months that's $34,000 a year for one employee, one helper. That means you're still gonna have to do all the office work, all the invoicing, estimating, whatever, all that stuff is still gonna be you. This guy is just most likely just going to be the one that's helping you on the field. And imagine that, just for one person, you're paying $34,000 a year. Now, could you imagine 12 a year? Employees, they're going to cost you money. So depending on how many you need to get started, you know, it's going to vary. But if you're trying to hire someone full time, it's going to cost you at least, you know, 35 grand a year. And that's at $18 an hour. I don't know. We're in LA, so that's pretty average minimum wage. I don't think you're going to find anyone who's going to work for less than that in construction. So next we have overhead. Now, what is overhead? Overhead is everything from your office space, like your rent for your office space, your phone bills, your website, your fuel, Wi-Fi, bookkeeping software. Like, there's so many things that can go into your overhead, but typically your overhead are bills that you have to pay whether or not you're making money. So that's your rent, your bills, gas to go to and from job sites. You could average this out, but depending on how far you're going, your fuel is going to vary. But still, you still have to go to work, so you should account for a fuel expense every month, you know, internet costs and stuff like that. My overhead is about $23.90, and that's, you know, on the low end. You know, This also includes any employees that you're going to hire just for the office, because your office employees are going to get paid whether or not you're getting jobs or not. There's a lot of stuff that people don't take into account. And also when you're bidding jobs, you know, I know a lot of people who don't include their overhead for whatever reason. Why? I don't know. They think it like doesn't, it's not related to the job, but it is, because you have to pay that no matter what. So you have to include a percentage of your overhead. The way I do it is whatever my monthly overhead is, I divide it into 30 days, turn it into a percentage, and then add that onto your bills. But that's in another video where we're gonna go over estimating and all that stuff. So roughly the total estimated cost to start a construction company, $144,530. Which is basically what SoCal used to get started up. We invested $150,000 to get SoCal up and running. I broke it down in another video, but pretty much the majority of it was the equipment, the payroll, and the materials to get started. But we already had a contract signed and ready to go. I don't want you guys spending this much or going to get a loan if you don't have any work already lined up. This is only if you signed the deal, you got the contract, now they want you to produce the work. If you don't have any signed contracts ready to go, if you don't have work lined up to cover this $150,000 loan or investment, then do not go get a small business loan for this amount just because you think it's going to cost you this much. You never want to borrow money unless you absolutely have to. And if you are going to borrow the money, make sure that you can pay it off. If you don't think you can pay it off, don't borrow the money. You're looking at about 150 grand. That's on average. But like I said, that's only because we already had contracts signed, ready to go. And we knew we were going to make more than 150 grand. So, but that's about it. But like I said, if you're just starting 10, 15, 20K, if you're just going to start off small, get your little power tools. If you're going to do all the work yourself, 15 grand will probably help you get started. Especially also if you're not going to buy the truck cash, if you have good credit. That's why I said in the beginning, if you have good credit, it's really going to help you out, because then instead of paying $35,000 for a truck, you can finance it and let it pay for itself over time as you get more jobs and get more work. Hope you guys enjoyed that video. Hope you found it very informative. We're going to go into depth into a lot of more stuff like this. So if you guys are enjoying it so far, make sure you guys leave me a comment on YouTube, social media, whatever. And we'll see you guys in the next video.